of F through S. Yeah.
What on earth's he doing?
Proofs.
Proofs?
Yeah.
You should let him run, Hardy. You shouldn't stifle him.
He's gone to the cricket. Just follow the umbrella.
Sir! Mr. Hardy! Mr. Hardy!
I've been over those proofs of yours, if you can call them that, very carefully. And I've marked where you're missing steps and where you've made mistakes. There's much more I could say, but that's where you should begin. Listen, I'm hard on you for your own benefit, so that you can be published.
But, sir, you can publish the notebooks and my prime number theorem. You've had them since I arrived.
There's nothing I'd like more, but if I was to publish them in their present state, I'd be sent to the lunatic asylum.
You don't understand these. I don't think about this the same way you do. These steps you want, what you want, I do not know how to do.
Well, you can just begin by trying your best and see if you don't surprise yourself.
Sir, do you know something I don't?
Apparently not. Oh, no. God and I don't see exactly eye to eye. So if I prepare for rain, then it won't. So far, so good. I am Hardy, and I'm spending the afternoon in the Wren Library. Now we're sure to have sunshine. You see, I'm what you call an atheist.
No, sir. You believe in God, you just don't think he likes you.
Oh, really? Listen, I wasn't going to give you this just yet, but I took the liberty of doing some of your proofs myself, just to show you what together we can achieve. See? You've been published.
Mr. Hardy, thank you! Thank you, sir!